Hi, this is Aaron and Linda with Traveling Flamingo, and today we're at Tony's Town Square Restaurant, right there on Main Street, USA, in the Magic Kingdom at Walt Disney World in Florida, and we're going to tell you what we think of this restaurant. A lot of people have said that it's one of the worst restaurants in the Magic Kingdom, and we're going to go ahead and tell you what we had, what the menus got, and what you can expect if you decide to eat here on your next trip to the Magic Kingdom. All of that coming right up.
So let's start with the atmosphere and theming. It is based on the Lady and the Tramp movies. Specifically, this is the Tony restaurant where Lady and the Tramp have their infamous spaghetti and meatballs and get to share that little kiss. So yes, of course, they've got the famous spaghetti and meatballs that you can also order and enjoy. And there's tons of Lady and the Tramp art around the restaurant and beautiful sculptures. It is an Italian-themed restaurant. And I think that the art and the sculptures are probably the best part for me in the restaurant.
So on to location. This is, as I said, right on Main Street when you walk into the Magic Kingdom. It'll be on your right-hand side. It shares the entrance with the Mickey Meet and Greet, which is in the Town Square Theater. You have great views of the parade when it's going on, so you can sit outside. They've got a little bit of outdoor area there, and you can watch the parade as it goes by. There's no real view here of the fireworks, so if you're planning on seeing the fireworks over dinner, you're not going to see it here. However, it is right in the Magic Kingdom. It is one of the food options that you have while you're in the park, so it's very convenient. However, we also have a bunch of other reviews of different food restaurants in the Magic Kingdom, such as the Plaza Restaurant and Skipper Canteen, both of which might be things that you consider eating at. So we will leave a couple links in the description, and they should be popping up on your screen if you're interested in watching those videos.
The location is pretty epic, actually being one of the first restaurants, or I think the first restaurant you come into when you come in the Magic Kingdom, with the view of the flag and the parade. You can see the train station right there. So the location is really nice as well. Onto the menu. It's got lots of Italian food, but nothing too adventurous. You'll get your typicals: pizza, spaghetti, chicken parmesan, fettuccine Alfredo, your very typical Italian pasta dishes. We had some nice apps like the fried mozzarella, and there are a lot of create your own options for kids, which is a great option as well, so that you know that your kids are going to be getting something that they can enjoy too, because at the park it can be a long day and you want to make sure everyone's getting all the energy and nutrition that they need.
So on to what we had. We had fried mozzarella. This was $12. We had garlic knots for $9. These currently don't seem to be on the menu. Hopefully this is just a pared down menu with COVID going on right now. However, we really hope that they'll be back. The garlic knots were great. I had a Peroni, which was a beer, and I also ordered a pepperoni pizza. That was $21.
The apps were definitely my favorite part of the food experience here. As Aaron said, the fried mozzarella was really nice, and the garlic knots, too bad they're not on the menu. I think I would actually consider asking if they can make them if we go back, because I really like those. We've actually made them a couple times since being home. And the pepperoni pizza was a pretty good size. So we actually ended up sharing all of this, and I felt like I had a pretty good meal.
Yeah, the pepperoni pizza was really good. It was a large pepperoni pizza. I quite enjoyed it. Not the best pizza I've ever had, but, you know, better than something like Pizza Rizzo, which we also do have a review of if you're interested in watching. It was good. The garlic knots were amazing. I liked the fried mozzarella as well. It tasted pretty good. Overall, there wasn't anything here that I felt wasn't great. From a value and price perspective, pretty good value, because, you know, for $21, it's a pretty big pizza. You're in general looking at about $20 to $30 to eat here. Appetizers are around $10 to $15. But the food quantity is pretty big. The pizza was pretty large. A lot of the plates that we saw were fairly large. So you can go ahead and share that with somebody that you're with, which is really great. They do accept Disney Dining Plan and Tables in Wonderland. And again, this is just a good restaurant with decently sized portions for a pretty good price. You know, $21 for a pizza, you might be thinking is a lot, but you got to remember you're in Disney. And, you know, again, it was fairly large and we were able to share it, and it was, you know, tasted pretty good.
So this was our second time going, and we sat in what I would call the conservatory, so the glassed-in area, and it was sort of cool because we were there during the fireworks time. It was the only time we could get a reservation, and you could sort of see the fireworks going off. I think that I did like that area and the openness of it. So like looking back on a whole, I did enjoy the apps. The servers were great. You know, the restaurant was clean. The food was pretty fresh. As I said, I enjoyed the apps the most. The price was okay. You are in the Magic Kingdom, so you do have those prices. But would I go back? No. There are other places. When we get to go to Disney and there's so many restaurants you'd like to go to, I would actually rather just go to Pecos Bill and get, you know, my food quick and at a decent price, be able to sit down. I think part of it is just also having an air conditioning break. So regardless of where you want to go, especially in the summer, is making sure you do take that break to sit down and eat. But I don't need to pay these prices and have an okay meal to do that. I also really enjoy the Plaza restaurant. I think that they have got great American food as well. That's also really shareable at much better prices. Or even Skipper Canteen. Their rooms and theming is amazing. So I just sort of feel this didn't hit it for me in terms of would I be spending my precious Disney time, Magic Kingdom time to be going back there? Probably not.
Yeah, I'm a bit mixed as well. I enjoy the food. The food here was pretty good. I liked the Italian food. It's, you know, probably better than a lot of the sit-down restaurants, but you know, yeah, if you're going to want to eat, Pecos Bill is a great place to just get some food, you know, get a bit of air conditioning and then get back to the parks. So I think it's really about what you want to do. If you've got a bunch of kids who might be a bit fussy, who do like Italian food, this is probably a great restaurant for you. On the flip side, if you're just trying to get some food quick, you know, you can probably go to Pecos Bill, which is much better than this. So yeah, I'm a bit mixed. You know, I would probably pick this as, you know, sort of in the middle rank of my sit down restaurants in the Magic Kingdom. I've had worse, I've had better. But if you do want a sit down restaurant, it's pretty good. If that's not what you're looking for, I always suggest Pecos Bill.
Again, with many of these Disney restaurants, you're going to want to make sure you have a reservation. They do get busy. We did see people turned away, or as what happened to us is we booked late and ended up having our dinner during the fireworks. So depending your trip, if fireworks are a must do or your parade is a must do, then make sure that you're booking early enough and not having this overlap with times of event that you really want to experience and go to. So we'd love to hear from you. Please do let us know in the comments below. Have you eaten here before? What's your favorite restaurant in the Magic Kingdom? Any good comparisons or recommendations? We do love having that dialogue with you. Thank you very much also for spending your time watching our video and making it this far in. We do hope that you enjoyed it. So if you did, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button because we got lots more content coming for you guys. So thanks again for watching and happy travels.